Welcome to Minity Maths. In this video, we are going to explain what fractions are, what equivalent fractions mean, and how to cancel down and simplify fractions. We will then provide some practice questions and answers. Please subscribe to our channel for weekly maths videos. What is a fraction? A fraction is just a way for us to show a part of a whole. We take a whole, such as a whole number, a whole circle, a whole pizza for example, and we divide it into equal parts. A fraction will describe how many of those parts we have. The number at the bottom of the fraction is called the denominator and shows us how many equal parts we have divided the whole up by. In this case, we have divided the whole up into four equal parts. The numerator is the number shown at the top and shows us how many of these equal parts we actually have. In this case, we have 3 out of the 4 equal parts, as 3 of the 4 parts are shaded. In other words, we have 3 quarters. Because a whole can be divided up in many different ways, there are many different ways we can write the same fraction. For example, if we divide our circle and rectangle up into 8 equal parts, we can say we have 6 out of the 8 parts, as 6 out of the 8 parts are shaded. In other words, 6 eighths. We can actually divide them even more, into 16 equal parts, and here we end up with 12 out of the 16 parts, in other words, 12 sixteenths. As you can see, we don't actually have any more or any less than we did when we had divided it into 4 parts. We are just showing how much we have, but in different ways. Therefore, these fractions are all equivalent. In other words, they all show the same amount. To find an equivalent fraction, all you have to do is multiply or divide both the numerator and denominator by the same number. Let's have a look at these fractions again. To get from the first fraction to the second, we have multiplied both the numerator, 3, and the denominator, 4, by 2. This will work for any fraction. As long as you do the same to the bottom number as you do to the top number, you can multiply the fraction by any number. Let's look at a question. Which of these fractions are equivalent to 1 over 4? 10 over 40 is equivalent, as both the top and bottom have been multiplied by 10. The next two fractions are not equivalent, as the top and bottom of the original fraction has not been multiplied by the same number. 5 over 20 is equivalent, as both numbers have been multiplied by 5. 8 over 32 is also equivalent, as the numerator and denominator have been multiplied by 8. Finally, 4 sixteenths is equivalent to a quarter, as the top and bottom have both been multiplied by 4. We can also find equivalent fractions by dividing. This is slightly trickier, as we have to find a number that divides by both the numerator and denominator. Let's take a look at our original example. Here we can divide 12 over 16 by 2 or even by 4 to get an equivalent fraction. Here we are actually simplifying the fraction, and the process is called cancelling down. Once we can no longer cancel the fraction down, we can say it is in its simplest form. Let's look at a question. If we are asked to write the fraction in its simplest form, we could keep dividing by 2 until we reach the smallest numbers. Or, we could simply try to think of the largest number that will divide into both 24 and 36. In this case, it's the number 12. Have a go at these practice questions. Pause the video while you figure them out. Thank you for watching this video. Subscribe to our channel and comment below with video suggestions.